sometimes people forget exactly how to use substance words, words that convey specific meanings. And so instead of saying car, they say driving thing. Instead of saying toothbrush, they say mouth thing. And so the specific substance words, they have a harder time getting it. So they begin to talk around it or use vague, less descriptive terms. And that can be a sign of dementia.
Forgetfulness is one of the most frustrating things in life. It doesn't matter whether you forgot why you walked into a room or what you were about to say. It's a natural part of life and aging, but only to a certain point. It can be one of the earliest signs of dementia. The condition causes many natural functions to suffer, with memory and speech being two of the first to go. Noticing these signs early is the best way to keep them from progressing. Keep watching to learn the early signs to look for before dementia takes over your brain. The prevalence of dementia. 47 million people around the world have dementia, including 5.5 million in the U.S. alone. Alzheimer's is the most common type that patients experience. Deaths from Alzheimer's have risen in recent years. That's partially due to the rising aging population. There are no medications to ease or reverse it. The best course of action is to look for early signs, and one of the first to check for is changes in speech. How it affects speech. Dementia can affect a patient's vocabulary. It may cause seniors to be unable to find the right word, replace them without malapropisms, or get lost in the middle of a conversation. The general term for having any forms of difficulty with speech and writing is aphasia. As a professional explains,
aphasia is a condition that affects a person's ability to communicate. And this can be pretty common in dementia, as the dementia impacts the part of the brain that's responsible for language. To break this down on a very basic level, there are, we'll say, two broad categories of aphasia. There is comprehensive aphasia and expressive aphasia. When we think about comprehensive aphasia, we think about comprehending. It's the ability for somebody to comprehend or understand language. So when somebody has difficulty with comprehensive aphasia, also known as receptive aphasia, then they're going to have a hard time understanding what you are saying.
Parents gradually begin to struggle more and more with choosing or remembering the right words or understanding what's being said to them. They may also struggle to read and write. It eventually begins to affect their social and professional interactions. The ability to speak can even become completely lost. There are three subtypes that relate to dementia. Lopagenic causes difficulties comprehending speech and finding the right word. Agrammatic or non-fluent causes confused word order and a reluctance to speak. Semantic causes difficulty naming familiar objects or comprehending the meaning of words. It's also possible for patients to display characteristics of more than one subtype. What studies have found? Researchers have done a great deal of work to try to understand the complex factors behind and signs of dementia. In one study, participants described a picture they saw in sessions taped 2 years apart. Those with early stage mild cognitive impairments had more slip-ups or difficulty remembering speech than those who didn't. Study leader Kimberly Muller admits that word recall issues are inevitable, but notes the difference between normal changes and signs of dementia. They say, quote, in normal aging, it's something that may come back to you later, and it's not going to disrupt the whole conversation. The difference here is it is more frequent in a short period, interferes with communication, and gets worse over time. A picture description test with 400 participants without cognitive problems showed no change in time in their verbal skills. The same test was run on 264 participants at the Wisconsin Registry for Alzheimer's Prevention. They had parents with the condition and were at a higher risk for it. 64 of the participants in that study had already shown signs of early mental decline. They declined faster in specific factors. They had trouble with expressing ideas and used more pauses and filler words. They also used more pronouns, such as it or they, instead of the names of items. They spoke in shorter sentences and took longer to convey ideas. Julie Liss, another researcher and speech expert from Arizona State University, said these were all signs of the brain struggling. She's done a large amount of research on the subject, including analyzing press conferences by former President Ronald Reagan to find evidence of Alzheimer's before he was diagnosed. She even founded a company that analyzes speech problems in neurological problems like dementia, traumatic brain injuries, and Parkinson's disease. None of these researchers could give a precise cost estimate of how much it would take to replicate their research for any single patient. They do believe it could be the new frontier in testing because it only requires a tape recorder and a computer program or app to analyze the results. Other early signs. Memory loss in all forms is the most well-known early sign of dementia-related diseases. It can cause seniors to forget almost anything. They can also have spatial and visual issues. They can struggle to drive, fail to understand colors, or be unable to judge distances. Hearing loss is an often ignored early sign of dementia. Taylor Fields, a doctoral student, studied 783 participants from the Wisconsin Registry. Those who were diagnosed with hearing loss at the beginning of the study were twice as likely to develop mild cognitive impairments in the next 5 years as those who had not. Impaired problem-solving skills are a sign of dementia. This problem can be compounded when aphasia makes it difficult to understand instructions being said to them. It's also a reason many seniors with the condition need caregivers. They may be unable to complete or focus on tasks they used to be able to do easily. What makes the condition even more dangerous is that it can affect a senior's sense of space and time. They can forget what time it is, where they are, and how they got there. It can also lead them to forget dates, but remember them later. Agitation and mood changes are common and can be combined with aphasia. What could be more aggravating than knowing what you want to say, but being unable to say it? This can cause patients to lash out or swear, even at their family. How to stave off dementia? There are some steps to take to stave off the disease. As a TED Ed video on the difficulties of treating Alzheimer's notes,
staying active, learning new skills, and even participating in daily activities like household chores seems to slow disease progression.
Aerobic exercise is one of the best methods for managing symptoms, especially for preventing speech issues. It's even been proven to help with aphasia after a stroke. It's believed that it may prevent the buildup of plaque on the brain that the condition creates. The physical side isn't the only thing to keep in mind. It's also important to keep the mind active with activities such as mind games and puzzles. Diagnosis and treatment. The diagnosis process begins with a physical examination. It may also include a comprehensive neurological examination and other tests such as the verbal fluency test or Boston naming test or brain imaging. There's even a way to start testing yourself for dementia if you notice any early symptoms. You can complete the self-administered gerocognitive exam or SAGE test online on your own. There are multiple correct answers, and a healthcare provider must score the test. When you get a diagnosis, treatment options are limited, but new ones are being discovered regularly.
Medications that target neurotransmitters, the brain's signaling molecules, can slow memory loss and help with learning and reasoning, and scientists continue to develop new therapies. For example, drugs that target beta amyloid have shown promise in slowing the disease and reducing plaque accumulation in the brain.
A speech and language therapist can help improve your loved one's speech problems. There are also emerging treatments to improve memory, such as transcranial magnetic stimulation and transcranial direct current stimulation. How to help family members? Being a caregiver or a loved one of a patient with dementia can be almost as distressing as having the condition yourself. Communication frustrations run both ways, but there are ways to make it easier. One expert recommends
work in more nonverbal communication, using things through gestures, body cues, facial expressions, sometimes written words or images. That kind of communication can work well for people who have aphasia.
Your method of speech also matters. Staying calm and clear is essential. Another expert explains
you want to have a calm, slow voice. If they don't understand what you said, repeat the exact same thing you said. Don't reword it. And get down to their eye level and try not to have too many people in the room at once.
Special communication strategies aren't always enough. You may need a bit of professional help to find the best way to communicate with your loved one. As one expert states,
my primary biggest recommendation is going to be to request an evaluation with a speech therapist. Sometimes they're called speech pathologists. It's the same thing, a speech therapist or a speech pathologist getting a full comprehensive evaluation. These types of evaluations are not just to see the level of impairment the person has with their speech and what they're able to do. One of the greatest things that they can do, and I've worked with some amazing speech therapists in the past, is that based on what the struggle is for the person with dementia, they can help develop the best communication methods for the caregiver and the person with dementia. They can talk about what would work best based on the level of impairment, and that's priceless, quite honestly.
Now it's time to hear from you. What medical condition would you like to know more about? Let us know in the comments section below.